Welcome back. There is no shortage of grocery stores across the metro area, and that, of course, means a lot of choices for how you feed your family.
But if you find yourself trying to get the best bang for your buck, News 3 Now's Josh Spreider shows you how to find affordable groceries in Madison.
It's just nice to feel like you're buying things that are fresh.
Marcy DeGrief is always in search of the best deals at the grocery store.
Trying to feed a family of four, you do try to take advantage of sales when you can.
What makes it even more difficult, the mother of two wants to find local produce and local meat especially.
Most importantly, I usually look for local farms, and then from there, I may price out between a couple different places.
She says she usually ends up at the Willie Street Co-op, where she can buy just the right amount of food she needs to feed her family.
Sometimes bulk means buying 12 or 24 of things, but for us it means buying as much or as little as you need.
The co-op's Brendan Smith says you often get better deals buying from the bulk aisle because of the savings on packaging and transportation. Bulk meaning taking home exactly what you need.
If you just need a tablespoon of cinnamon or a cup of flour, you can buy just that amount.
That's also one of the tips registered dietitian nutritionist Emmy Bodden has for grocery shoppers. But before you go to the store, your work starts at home.
The first thing that I do myself is kind of look up the deals. So whether it's the grocery store's weekly circular or the deals that are in the grocery store's own app.
Then find what's right for you and your family. So if produce is your focus, she says find what store has your favorite products and go from there. Also, don't skip the frozen foods aisle because it can save you time and money.
Frozen foods can be picked at their prime, they're frozen at their prime, and they're shipped frozen. So they retain their nutritional value. And being picked at their prime, they often have that higher nutritional value to start with.
And if you're really trying to save money,
shopping local can save you some money, and it can ensure, like you said, that products don't take a long time to get to you. That can retain a lot of the nutritional value too. Plus, it supports local businesses, which is always a good thing.
That means staying away from meal kit delivery companies you often see online, even though the food conveniently comes right to your door with all the ingredients.
I think that you can get a lot more bang for your buck if you're purchasing individual ingredients and making your own meal out of them versus getting those ingredients pre-cut, pre-chopped, and prepackaged sent to you. That really ups the price tag without upping the portion size too.
Marcy tells me she will continue to find the best deals and shop locally.
I very much like the feeling of knowing where the food comes from.
She encourages others not to take the abundance of options for granted after living in parts of the country where it just doesn't exist.
Accessibility is huge here to be able to get those things, unless you're growing it yourself, which is obviously the best way to do it, but we don't have time for that.
In Madison, Josh Spreider, News 3 Now.
If you have any questions on how to save at the grocery store, you can find a link to Real Good Nutrition at channel3000.com.